Hey guys, it's Bro You Whack, and there's been tons of news around Overwatch lately. There's gonna be new Season 7 content coming up soon, a new collaboration with the K-pop group Les Serafins gonna be happening, support heroes in Overwatch 2 are gonna be getting nerfed in the mid-season patch, and BlizzCon's also gonna be coming out.
Wait, what did you just say?
That there's a new Murphy plush being sold that looks adorable?
No, the part where support heroes are getting nerfed in the mid-season patch.
Alright, enough goofing around. There was a blog posted today that went into detail talking about the Sombra rework, the up-and-coming Roadhog rework, also changes to the competitive system, and what's going to be announced at BlizzCon, but more importantly, what you're probably here to talk about are the new support hero changes coming in the mid-season patch. And I use the word changes in a hopeful manner because maybe it won't just be a bunch of nerfs,
but it'll probably be just a bunch of nerfs.
In the blog post, they specifically said that they're happy with the overall state of balance in Season 7. Well, it doesn't really seem like if you're wanting to nerf a lot of support heroes, but let's continue. We've seen a lot of talk around supports and their rising power level in the meta. We're making a series of changes to many of the support heroes in the game for the mid-season patch with the intent of targeting their utility and opening up windows of vulnerability. So the key word here is many. They're looking to nerf many of the support heroes. Not one, not two, but also not all. So you Mercy mains that are scared that maybe your precious hero might get nerfed, it's possible, but why? Why is this happening? Well, I'm sure you've heard lots of people complain, besides support mains, saying that their damage is getting outmatched by the enemy support hero's heals. I mean, let's just use a common example that lots of people have been complaining about. Let's say you're playing someone like Soldier 76 and you're targeting an Orisa. That's a pretty easy target to hit. However, that Orisa is getting double pocketed by an Ana and an Illyari. So that Orisa not only has so much sustainability because of her own hero kit, but she's somehow gaining more health than you're doing damage, making it nearly impossible to take out that Orisa, which means that you really have to focus those backline supports, but it's kind of hard if they either have high mobility or if they're deep in the enemy backline, where if you go to try to focus them, you're gonna get shot. And shoot, people even making the argument for a solo support hero out healing the damage on like a tank or just really anybody. And look, that's just a blanket situation that just tries to paint the picture as to why this is happening. Basically, in layman's terms, support heroes are doing their job too well. But to make the situation even more comical, in the blog post, they even mentioned like a hero like Orisa, from a stats perspective, is not the problem, but rather the supports are the problem. Orisa isn't even the best tank in Overwatch. Rather, in the lower divisions, it's Reinhardt, and in the higher divisions, it's Sigma. I just found it so funny how Blizzard is seemingly pawning the blame as to why the meta blows so much pee-pee right now from one hero to another. Like, originally it was Orisa, and then once they differ. So, oh wait, no, never mind. It was actually support heroes, but I know I'm laughing right now, but this is somewhat of a serious issue because I know support mains are getting frustrated right now because, well, the whole point why they went through so many changes throughout the whole entire year was so that they can have better utility and have more sustainability, where in the blog post, they literally said they're looking to target a support hero's utility and sustainability. I can see the frustration. Like, me personally, I don't really like how much utility and sustainability Batiste gives because he has an immortality field. He has an AoE heal, he has a spam heal, he also has great DPS, so I can see him getting nerfed, but then a hero like Ana, well, she doesn't have much survivability, so does she really deserve to get nerfed? Well, we're just gonna have to see, but I really think they're gonna be looking to nerf things that don't really hinder a good support main's ability to do well. So stuff like possibly increasing cooldown times for abilities, yeah, like it's still a nerf, but this is so that it can hurt players that just willy-nilly use abilities and don't really think about the timing at which you use it. Also looking to nerf speed at which mobile abilities are used, so like Mercy's Flight or Illyari's Burst Jump. That way it's a little bit easier to kill those moving targets, because I know lots of people complain about Mercy's Slingshot ability, basically. But also looking to maybe nerf a little bit of the amount of heals that these support heroes gives. Ultimately, that is the biggest problem with support heroes, is that maybe they do give a little bit too much heals, and they survive a little bit too long, but I feel like nerfing their survivability and not nerfing their heals, I think could be the answer, because, well, bad support players will be punished, but good support heroes that find a way to survive won't be. But again, that's coming from a player that doesn't play a lot of support heroes and also isn't really a support main. But another hero that they seemingly just single singled out of all heroes besides support heroes is Bastion, where they're going to be looking to nerf his assault form in the mid-season patch, along with other heroes as well. But Bastion, he's definitely one of the better, I would say he's the best DPS hero right now, just because of the double pocket situation that we mentioned before, but also because he delivers the best amount of DPS that any hero can give right now in the game. Literally looking to make that old TikTok into reality, where they
nerf Bastion.
Now, another thing that they talked about that they actually introduced in this blog post with was the Sombra rework, which turned out to be a great success. The rein rate of Sombra increased by 4-5%, which in the grand scheme of things, as statistics wise, that's a huge massive win, because beforehand I think Sombra had like a 37 win percentage or something. Definitely a bottom tier here who definitely needed to get reworked. In my personal opinion, I've been having a lot of fun with Sombra. She's one of my favorite DPS heroes to play. However, I think the reason why she's my favorite is because her abilities are very effective, and they're actually looking to nerf her EMP and some of her cooldowns to her abilities, which I definitely think was needed. It's just way too easy to perform some of her abilities, like her virus and her translocator, so I think increasing it by a second or two is definitely needed. However, the other hero that was looking to get reworked in Season 7 as well was Roadhog during the mid-season patch. Well, his rework is now delayed later on in the season rather than the mid-season patch of when it was originally scheduled. Oh, that's so annoying. I swear, this Roadhog rework has been talked about ever since like last year, since December of 2022, I think. And the fact that it's getting delayed once again is so frustrating, but at this point, it's whatever. Roadhog has always been a polarizing hero. He's either the best tank to play with his one-shot hook capability or the worst tank to play with his feeding ability. So hopefully with this rework, he can just finally just be a normal tank. Like, my God. But they're looking to rework his self-healing ability, his primary fire, and also looking to give him a new ability. So similar to what happened with Sombra, kinda. But the other thing that they mentioned in this blog post, very slight, that I don't know if it's a big deal, but they said that they will be announcing the brand new Season 8 tank hero at BlizzCon. And the reason why I say that this isn't really that surprising, maybe, is because we all kind of expected a new hero to be announced at BlizzCon, because it's happened every BlizzCon. This is the biggest stage that Blizzard has, and I doubt that they would save a hero announcement for just a simple YouTube video. No, you're gonna have it at BlizzCon. Later on in a couple of days, I will have my BlizzCon predictions video come out, so be on the lookout for that. But I'm excited for this year's BlizzCon, because we're already getting a lot of taste of what's to come for BlizzCon, but also the rest of the year for Overwatch. But the final thing that they slightly mentioned was talking about competitive changes and maybe changes to the shop. The wording was very weird when it came to the shop, but when it comes to competitive changes, they realize that competitive is complete dog water right now. So at BlizzCon, they're going to be looking to announce some up and coming competitive changes, whether that's with a new system, going back to the old system. I'm not too sure that's what the announcement is for at BlizzCon, but we can expect some competitive changes getting announced at the biggest convention for Blizzard there. But in terms of the shop, they heard a lot of complaints about Lilith Moira only being available in the expensive skin bundle, and that they said that they're looking to change that in the future, which is confusing because, well, are you gonna like do this again, or are you not gonna, like, I don't know what you mean by that. Obviously you learned your lesson, but are you just gonna stop doing skin bundles from here on out? Probably not, but who's to know. But that's all the brand new things talked about in the blog post. Again, the K-pop collaboration was announced the day before, so if you haven't seen my video where I talk about that collaboration, be sure to check out that video. But until the next announcement, or until BlizzCon, I love you guys. Thank you guys for watching. More Overwatch 2 videos to come, and bye.